Welcome back to my channel. So in this video, I would like to share with you what is the security features available in the Adafruit. Okay, as you know, the Adafruit is one of the major IoT product that can give you a very good idea about sharing your data being collected from a microprocessor or microcontroller such as Arduino, Raspberry Pi, Microbit and so on. So recently, I got an email from the Adafruit mentions that the compromisations of the API key. So the reason of this is because of one of my own GitHub being attached with the Arduino code with my existing running conditions of the API key. So this video is just to share with you how important to you to change your API key frequently, especially if you're making up a video and also sharing to the public. And then I also want to give a credit to the Adafruit IO because they give a very good protection mechanism with regard to this news. Okay, when there is something breached with your numbers or with your API token, they will give you automatically. So this is not a big issue for me because I'm just trying to understand also the mechanism of sharing coding in the GitHub. But it's turned around that the Adafruit giving me opportunity to understand also the security features available. So if you share your API key publicly, so the Adafruit automatically give you hint to change your API key immediately. So I think that's all I want to share with this video. Hopefully you can protect and secure your own data and also your own microcontroller in terms of sharing the data to the public. Okay, let me just conclude everything with showing to you about my dashboard. So perhaps you want to learn more about what I'm doing with this IoT project. So let me just open it. Okay. So if you want to learn more about the use of this Adafruit product and also their services, so please visit to io.adafruit.com, and then this is my dashboard. If you click to this dashboard or if you write this dashboard on your browser, you have the opportunity to see about my output regarding the temperature and also environmental conditions of my room. So this is a very nice features given by the Adafruit. So it is a lifetime data collection process, and then I also record it in a very understandable condition, which is with the delay of the 5 minutes once the data will be fired from my ESP32, and then it's being sent to the Adafruit IO to represent something like this. So if you want to download the data also, you can, but you need to of course become a member and register into the Adafruit IO. So with that, thank you very much for watching this video, and see you again trying to make an interesting and beautiful mechanism using Adafruit. Bye bye.